talk to us about our FUMC Champaign Foundation?
Thank you. Good morning.
Hi.
I'm here today to tell you about a legacy that our church has that you might not even be aware of. I'm Wes Curtis, your current president of the First United Methodist Church Foundation. Did you even know that our church has a foundation? The foundation is a separate entity that was created in 1999 to be a resource to our church to help fund programs and activities. The foundation holds and invests numerous endowment funds. An endowment fund is where the principal remains untouched, while the income or earnings from the principal are spent for various programs and activities. Our church has a great legacy of endowment giving. Over 100 years ago, in 1915, Mrs. Celestia Young Wolf, our first female Sunday school teacher, created the first endowment fund for our church with a very generous gift of $25,000. That amount is worth almost $600,000 in today's dollars. In 1923, Mrs. Wolf added $10,000 more to the fund, bringing it to a total of $35,000. And that money has remained intact in the endowment to this day, even during the Great Depression, providing income throughout the years to support our church. Many other church members throughout the years have made gifts to the church's endowment fund, which is giving that is up and beyond the regular annual pledge giving where all the money is spent during one year. The church's endowment fund has grown from that $35,000 in 1923 to $2.5 million at the end of 2016. Last year, the foundation distributed $72,600 to the church's ministries, including our nurturing ministries, outreach ministries, worship and music ministries, and our church facilities. Okay, there he is. This happy guy up on the screen is you, a member of First United Methodist Church in Champaign. And the box, well, the box is a box, but it's also representing a building block which represents a foundation, your special legacy. And there's an equation there, you see a plus and the equal signs. So you take you and you add the foundation, what do you get? The continuation of a very special legacy that will last for another 100 years and beyond, benefiting the future generations of our church. In Friendship Center today, you will see display boards with more information about your foundation. We are grateful to Foundation Board Member Susan Weber for preparing this slide and all the material you will see in Friendship Center. Please take time today to check it out. And if you have questions, ask Susan or myself or one of our current other board members who are Grant Henry, Phyllis Robeson, Ron Fields, Howie Kemper, Linda Fosler, Nancy Nash, and Wayne Weber. Thank you.
Thank you, Wes, because of you, Ministries of Motion at First United Methodist Church. We're going to sing another song while the offering is taken called The King of Love. This is actually one of the favorites of Praise Dan. Hope it's a favorite of yours also. But interestingly enough, this song and the song that you just sang, Never Let Go, were actually based on the same song. So it's very different settings, different ways of saying the same thing about God's love. The ushers will wait on us now for the offering.
The kingdom of my shepherd is, whose goodness faileth never. I love him like if I am his, and he is mine forever. And he is mine forever. Where streams of living water flow, my ransom slowly leadeth. And where the burden pastures grow, with whom flesh shall be dead. Never tending, ruler of my heart, everlasting, lover of my soul, on the mountain high, for in the valley low, the kingdom of my shepherd is, the kingdom of my
Ethan Simmons, and he's graduating from University Laboratory High School, and next year year, he will be attending the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign College of Business. So if we could just give them a round of applause. And now I'm just going to tell you a little bit about our college and beyond graduates this year. So, Hannah Charter has graduated from the University of North Carolina, Wilmington with a Bachelor in Science degree in Environmental Science and a minor in Biology and Geographic Information Systems, so that is a mouthful. She plans to start a career in Geographic Information Systems like cartography and mapping via GIS analysis for an environmental company. Janice Chu graduated from the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign with a Bachelor of Science degree in Chemistry, and next year she will attend the Southern Illinois University School of Dental Medicine. Zach Forsyth graduated from Eastern Illinois University with a Bachelor's degree in Psychology. Next year he will start his Master's degree program at the University of Illinois in Social Work with a concentration in Mental Health. Carol Peterson is graduating from the University of Nebraska-Lincoln with a Bachelor's degree in Culinology with a minor in German, and this summer she'll be working through an internship. And Brent Corum graduated in December from the University of Iowa with a Doctor of Physical Therapy degree, and he and his wife Katie reside in Iowa City, and he's a practicing physical therapist in Cedar Rapids. So we're really proud of all these guys. So if you see these guys in between services and Friendship Center, we have cake for them, so stop by and say congratulations.
Such an exciting time of life, that's for sure, and we wish all the best for you guys, and like I say, very exciting time of life. Before our chancel ringers start, their selection today, The Tree of Life and an Awesome Mystery, is actually based on a poem by Marty Hagen, and so I'm going to read the poem so that you know the text of the music that you're going to be hearing. Tree of life, an awesome mystery. In your death, we are reborn. Though you die in all of history, still you rise with every morn. Seed that dies to rise in glory, may we see ourselves in you. If we live to live your story, we may die to rise anew. We remember truth once spoken, love passed on through act and word. Every person lost and broken wears the body of our Lord. Gentle Jesus, mighty Spirit, come inflame our hearts anew. We may all your joy inherit if we bear the cross with you. Christ, you lead and we shall follow, stumbling though our steps may be. One with you in joy and sorrow, we the river, you the sea.